Today, we will try to learn about the working mechanism of a dial indicator. Okay. Now, this dial indicator especially is a very small instrument. You can see here, it is a very small instrument which will give a very high magnification by using the gear and pinion in small area. So magnification can be achieved just by the gear and pinion mechanisms. Now, if you see this dial indicator, first I will give the outer parts of this dial gauge. Very first one, this one. You can see this black body. This is a bezel. This bezel is used to rotate to the zero. See, if you want to set it to the zero, we have to rotate this bezel. So this is how we can set it to the zero. Second part of this is to markers. These are the two markers so that we can set the limit. We can set the limit. Okay. This is the main purpose of this. Third is a point. You can see this is a point. This is a contact point, you can say, which is a very hardened one. And fourth is a plunger. So main purpose of this plunger is to, fourth part is a plunger. You can see this is a plunger. The plunger can be moved up and down. Then there are, this is a pointer, you can see, this is also called as a needle. This is also called as a needle. This is a needle. Or it is also called as a pointer to measure the numbers. And there are two scale, you can see. This is an outer scale which having a 100 division on this. And the second one, this is a counter scale. This counter scale is used for how many rotation has been taken by this pointer or the needle. See, this is a one rotation, second, third, fourth, and so on. So for that counter scale is provided. But today my interest is to give the explanation regarding to the working mechanism of a dial gauge. So what I had done already, I have already removed this cover. Okay, you can see here. Now these are the various internal parts if you want to show here. You know that this is a plunger, no doubt. Then along with that, there is a rack. Now this rack, you can see, it is a very small one. You can see here, this is the rack. This is a rack. Third important point is a pinion. This is a rack. Okay. Then the third one is the pinion. It's a very small part. It is a very small part. Okay. This is a pinion. I will show you how it, the movement will take place there. Here actually the pinion is. It is a very small one. I think, will it be visible to you? Part is a pinion. Okay. So I will show you the movements. Yeah, yes, see, this is how it moves. Okay, so this part is a pinion one. Okay, below that there is a gear, a very small part again. This is gear here. Even I show you the rotation of this. See, this is a, okay. Then this is a coil spring. Then this is a hair coil spring, you can see here. This is a hair coil spring. Even I will show the movement of this. You can see here, this is a hair coil spring. And last one, you can see this is one of the pin here, which is inserted into this slot. This is, I will move it. This is a slot. This is a slot. Okay. Now, how the working will take place here? A very first one, this plunger having a rack, okay, which is mesh with the pinion, Now, the rotation of this plunger, this is a plunger complete one, this rotation of this plunger about its own axis is prevented by this pin. You can prevent the rotation by this pin, which is located inside this slot. Okay. Then there are, to keep the plunger in a normal position, means exactly straight, for that we are using a light coil spring. You can see in this instrument. Now, the gear is, if you see this diagram, the gear is mounted on the same shaft as that of a pinion. Means this is a gear. Okay, this is a gear. This part is a gear. Like I said, this is a shaft there. The shaft of the gear, and the pinion, they are both mounted on the same shaft. Okay. So, the remaining gears are inside this. Means there is a gear train. If I remove this cover, there are the gear trains which can be observed. Even I can show you from this book also. You can. So, this is the, see the gear trains. This is a pinion. This is a gear. Means all they are intermediately connected with each other, so that we can achieve the magnifications, right? So high magnification can be achieved only due to this rack and pinion mechanisms. So here also I would like to say, this is a, these are the gear, again the various gears are there which is not visible in this. Okay. Now if you want, because when the movement takes place, naturally the gear, the backlash or runout will take place, or backlash will take place. So for that, this hair coil spring is provided. Okay. So this is how the internal structure or the mechanism of the dial indicator shows here. Now if you, I want to calculate the least count of these, how it is a very easy one. Now if I calculate it, you can see that the, there are 100 divisions, but the smallest division if you observe, okay, I will show you here. Suppose